The Texas Gulf Coast is full of hardworking families. Folks who rise with the sun to get things done. And around these parts, there's one family that's dedicated to supporting all these other families. We're Shoppa's, a premier John Deere dealership in the Lone Star State. And not only are we committed to serving the people of the area, we're a longtime dedicated member of this community.
I am the third generation. My grandfather started Shoppa's in 81, 82 with one store.
Betty and I both were raised on farm. So agriculture, farming was something that we had a strong interest in.
He had the background and wanted to help the local people, and he felt like he could put a business together that would do that.
Back in 1996, I had the opportunity to step in and work with my dad and play a role in transitioning this company from one generation to the next. We're a company now of 8 locations spread out across 38 counties, and we have over 200 employees.
Having the right people is important, and then having those people work as a team to provide quality service at a reasonable price is what makes that business really have success.
We have that desire to be a part of wherever we're located and to make an impact on the people in the communities where we have our dealerships.
Shoppa's has the network to deliver whatever customers need. But just as important, our can-do attitude and unsurpassed support ensure customers get just what they need, whether it's for large-scale farming or weekend yard work.
They make me feel wonderful over here because I'm the queen over here. When I come get my parts or my service, they jump, they're at my beck and call.
I deal with growers who are around 20 years old to growers that have been in the ag business for well over 60 years.
We love talking to all our customers, but especially first-time buyers. Determining what you need can be a challenge, but that's why we have sales professionals who know this equipment. Many of them have land themselves, and they can offer really good advice on what someone would need.
Of course, to offer this kind of support requires a deep understanding of this demanding business and the challenges our customers face. That's why Shoppa's employees receive training that is second to none. And we have the equipment and determination to bring that knowledge wherever it's needed.
That's the strength of Shoppa's. Our people are so knowledgeable. Even if you're not sure what you need, we know what you need.
We have a huge investment in service trucks with very experienced technicians running those trucks. The guys can do the job they need to do at the customer's place of business, so they don't have to worry about transporting that or bringing that in. That just helps them get back to the field faster.
Name of the game nowadays is no downtime. The way this weather works around South Texas is you don't have a big window. And when it's time to go, it's time to go.
Having support to back up our technology is vital to our business. We really strive here at Shoppa's to stay on the cutting edge of technology.
One thing you have to learn more than anything else is that efficiency is what drives the business. If you have equipment that you can't rely on, you lose your efficiency. In our experience, John Deere has been the most efficient equipment that we can have on the farm.
Over the years, a lot has changed in the ag business, and we've evolved with it. But not everything at Shoppa's has changed. We're still a Texas-owned family business, dedicated to helping your family.
We are only as successful as our customers are.
We truly have their best interest first and foremost. We want to have that same pride in our brand that they do. And I think if we can instill that in our employees and practice that, then we will always be a critical cog in their wheelhouse.
Guys are here tonight, and we have a great event planned for you this evening. We're excited to introduce to you tonight
the 2020 John Deere new product introduction.
You know, everybody here has a brand, and that brand in some cases is more than a symbol. It's an indication of hard work, of integrity. In some cases, it's generations old. It represents your heritage. It represents your heritage that you've worked the land. Your brand is yours for this generation, and hopefully you'll leave it better off for the next generation when you pass it along. John Deere's brand is 183 years old. It represents one purpose: to provide the best products in the world for those that work the land, for you guys. Shoppa's, we have our brand as well. It was passed down to me from my dad. It's represented by over 250 employees today. And hopefully one day I'll pass it down to my son, Will. I want to close by just telling you once again how proud we are to be a small player and play a small role in helping you guys be as productive as you possibly can and profitable as you possibly can. And together, we're represented by the world's leading agriculture company, and together we'll help you feed the world. Thanks and enjoy the evening.
Good evening, folks, and welcome to the product information intro that we're going to have tonight. My name is Carl Ludwig. I work out of the East Menard store, and they asked me to get up here for a few minutes and tell you how good John Deere equipment is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop in about 90 minutes and let you take a break. Seriously, they said I had about 2 minutes, but the guys that know me here, I can't do anything in 2 minutes, so just throw something at me when I get too long. But they gave me the pleasure of introducing and talking about the John Deere round balers. This is a new product. It has a new look to it. But I've been here about 15 years selling these balers, and basically what I'm so proud of is this is the same baler we had 15 years ago. Tried, proven engineering. But every year, John Deere listens to its producers and makes changes that make it better. For example, every time they have a product change, we've added things like high flotation tires to reduce your compaction rates. We've lightened the drive shaft weight to make it easier to hook up. We've made the chains heavier. We've made the shafts heavier. So what did they do this year? I said, what can you do to make it better? Well, some of you will know that we used to have a two-piece door with a seam in it that would rust out over time. They now made that a one-piece door. It's going to prevent a lot of trouble in the future. We added a plastic polymer door to the back to prevent dents that get knocked in it. They have a new brake system on the back that's guaranteed for 10,000 hours without adjustment. So what I'm saying is this is the greatest thing that John Deere could bring you. But what we're the most proudest of is I have generations of you guys that come back every couple of years and trade in your John Deere baler for another John Deere baler. That makes us proud to represent John Deere and their hay equipment. Now, I talked about the East Menard store. Another thing that we're very proud of, I don't know if you've driven up Highway 60 out of East Menard lately, but we're putting up a brand new facility there. The reason for that is you'll see tonight, John Deere equipment has grown in size. We built the John Deere store in the 60s to handle 4440s. Well, now we can't get CP 690s even through the door. So the Shoppa family has invested a lot of money in their employees as well as you valued customers. So we hope that's going to pay benefits for you in the future. We're hoping to be opened up by next summer to serve your needs. Now, we always talk about green on green solutions. John Deere pretty much designs their implements to match the quality of their tractors. So I'm going to turn it over to, and this is always a hit, my fighting Texas Aggie buddy, Derek, to tell you about our tractors.
Hey, I'm Derek Page. I'm out of the El Campo store. I'm going to talk to you again, like Carl said, on the green on green solution. We've got tractors to match every implement we put out. Our 6 Series is really one of those phenomenal tractors that we put out. It's basically a multi-tool as far as what's offered in the model lineup. We've got 3 different comfort levels. Come in E-Series, M-Series, R-Series, ranging from 105 horsepower all the way up to 250 horsepower. They're going to handle your light ranching task, your hay task, your cattle task, even some light row crop task. We've got an easy numbering system. So if you look at the tractor here behind us, the 6, you'll notice it's a little bit larger. It's a 6 Series tractor. The really cool part, the next 3 numbers, is 155. It's 155 engine horsepower.
It's real easy. M-Series tractor,
it's going to be that mid-comfort level. E-Series is going to be our entry-level tractor. I'm going to step back for a second to that. It kind of comes out of the factory how it is. We've got a few options. You can add some things, but if you're looking for an economical entry-level tractor, that's the way to go. M-Series is going to hit our mid-comfort level. It's got a little bit larger cab. We got some wheel and tire options. This one's got a rack and pinion axle. We got flange axles. Then you step up to the Cadillac. Cadillac's going to be the R-Series, biggest cab, leather seats. I mean, you name it, you can put it in there. I mean, they've thought of it all. Full line of loaders to go on all these tractors to fit all your needs. Lots of hydraulic options. Again, lots of transmission options in all of them.
So if y'all have any questions later,
y'all come see us down here on the floor. Carl and I will be standing here by the tractor and baler to answer any questions y'all have at the end of the program.
Good evening. I also would like to thank you all for coming tonight. I'm Kelby Bradley, sales manager with Shoppa's Farm Supply. I'm here with David Rose in sales out of El Campo, and we'll be bringing you the planter lineup. As you know, Deere has the proven MaxEmerge 5 planter. It's been tried and true for years and years. And recently we've come out with an electric drive, the 5E. The MaxEmerge 5E planter and the MaxEmerge ExactEmerge electric drive planter. The ExactEmerge has a brush belt technology that is now offered in cotton also. And it's been dubbed the high-speed planter, but it's truly not a high-speed planter. It's a planter that can plant accurately up to 10 miles an hour, but any speed in between. And the way that is accomplished, the seed comes out of the new design seed bowl, and it follows a brush belt all the way into the seed trench. No longer does it fall down a seed tube. So at any speed, it's not dropping the seed into the trench, it's placing the seed in the trench. And with some of this electric technology on the electric drive planters, you have single row runoff. You're able to, with the app on your phone, you're able to get behind the planter, do individual seed runoffs per unit, and that allows you to have basically a planter test stand in the palm of your hand. You can also adjust vacuum from that app on your phone as you're standing behind the planter. No more getting in and out of the cab. Some other things that comes with is turn compensation. With the electric drive, you're able to shut off each meter or speed each meter up individually instead of in sections. So as you're going around a curve, it allows the outside rows to speed up, the inside rows to stay at a slower pace, keeping your seat spacing at the rate you desire. You also have vacuum optimization, which allows you to set your vacuum level you want for that population. And while you're moving all day long, it is changing that level automatically to maintain that seat spacing. That's some of the things that's offered with the electric drive and the technology on these planters. David?
Thank you, Kelby. My name is David Rose. I'm in sales in El Campo. Like Kelly was talking about, these new row units are available as complete units, as you see on the floor here. We're very blessed to have these retail sold units here for us tonight to look at. As we move into the next year, we've been very blessed with great weather. It won't be long, we'll be all in the fields getting our seed in the ground. As you go through this next crop, just know that you may have a complete planter that's in very good shape, but you may want to take the opportunity to look at the green on green solution that Deere has provided with just by the row units. If you want a MaxEmerge 5, a 5E row unit, or even the new ExactEmerge, those units are now available as a kit that can be replaced. You can replace your row units and put those new units on your bar. Kelby and I look forward to introducing ourselves. If we haven't met you, we look forward to meeting you on the floor here in a little while. And good luck in this planting season. Thank you.
Thanks again.
Things are changing. It's the dawn of a new day at Des Moines Works. John Deere has been investing in application equipment technology since 1962. Your customers are changing. Des Moines Works is changing. The application business is changing. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the R4030 and R4038.
Good evening, and once again, welcome to the product introduction. I'm Rodney Jedlicka, based out of the El Campo store, and once again, we'd like to thank you for coming tonight, and also thank you very much for your business. What you see here in the show ring tonight is a John Deere R4038 sprayer. This sprayer is equipped with a 1,000-gallon fluid tank, 120-foot boom to get you across your field and get your fields covered. And some of you may say, Rodney, that's a little too big for me. I don't need nothing that big. Well, don't worry. We've got you covered with a smaller version of the R4023. The 4023 is equipped with a 600-gallon tank and booms in 60, 80, and 90 feet and has a crop clearance of about 53 inches. That's the smallest unit that John Deere offers today. And then some of you may say, I need something bigger. Well, don't worry, we've got you covered. We offer units in 800-gallon capacity, 1,000 like this unit, 1,200-gallon, and new this year, a 1,600-gallon tank on the R4060 sprayer. The R4030 through the R4060 series are available in boom widths of 100 foot, 120 foot, and also 90. You can also get that boom in 120 foot and 132 foot carbon fiber to lighten the load of that sprayer going across the field. And some of you may think, well, what else can we get you? A wise man once told me when he hired me, that technical stuff is technical, Rodney. Well, Mr. Shoppa had it right. John Deere's technology is improved from the ground up, and with these sprayers today, with guidance systems, we can get you headed in the right direction if you're going straight or if you want to turn. In curve compensation, we've got you going in the right direction. With section control, we can turn your nozzles off as you go across the field. We can help you map your fields, and we can do John Deere Connect through that system.
We also offer turn compensation, as Kelby mentioned earlier on the planters. That will allow you
to make those spray nozzles speed up on the outer section and slow down in the center sections. We can also take this sprayer and do whatever you need to do. We know that John Deere's got you covered. Now, I'm gonna turn it over to Steve, who's gonna take you up a little higher with the Hagee.
Thanks. Good evening, everyone. My name's Steve. I'm from the Hagee factory out of Clarion, Iowa. I'm sure many of you are wondering why there's a gray and yellow Hagee sprayer at a John Deere product introduction. Well, the truth is, many customers were asking for a solution that provided higher clearance and lighter weight machine. So, John Deere reached out and decided to partner rather than create a high clearance machine themselves. So Hagee's been in the business since 1947, manufacturing self-propelled applicators and detasseling equipment, but mainly throughout the Midwest. In 2017, John Deere and Hagee decided to form a partnership. This allowed John Deere exclusive rights to sell and service Hagee equipment all throughout the United States. So this means that Hagee still manufactures and designs in Iowa, but all the selling and servicing that you're used to receiving from your John Deere or Shoppa's dealer is all the same now for Hagee products. So today, Hagee manufactures five different models of Hagee sprayers, ranging from 1,000 all the way to 1,600 gallons. We have 72 inches of underframe clearance standard on all models. We also offer all-wheel steer, so all four wheels are able to turn at the same time, under 10 miles an hour. This allows you to maneuver into tight situations and also only leave two tracks if you're worried about running over crops, maybe on the headlands or at the end rows. Also, all of our models come with the front boom. So with the front boom, the engine's in the back. That allows a perfect 50-50 weight distribution between the front and the rear. So this allows this machine to be a little lighter than some of the competitors in the same capacity range. All of our booms go from 90 foot to 132 foot, all steel and aluminum composition. And these machines are all can be configured with ISG components. So the Starfire 6000s, the Gen 4 displays, the John Deere rate controllers you're used to, and your Deere equipment is all a factory option from Clarion, Iowa. So feel free, come on down after the show, walk around, ask me questions, ask me how to get this guy on your farm for a demo.
Good evening. My name is Trey Lucas, and I'm out of the Bay City store. Today, I would like to talk to you about the 9R family series of tractors. Inside the 9R tractors, we have three groups. First, we have the 9R wheeled machines. This consists of six models from 370 horsepower all the way up to 620 horsepower. Next, we have the 9RTs. This is a two-track machine, and we have three models, 470 to 570 horsepower. Then we have the 9RXs, the four-track machine. Here we have go from 420 horsepower all the way up to 620 horsepower. That's 14 machines. Of those 14 machines, 10 of them you can order with a scraper configuration. Which is the right machine for you? Well, a wheel track machine is nice. It's very versatile, but with a hydro cushion axle, you can keep that power to the ground, eliminate or minimize power hop, and leaves you with a nice ride. On the track machine, a 9RT, they're nice because it has a light footprint. When you compare a 9R wheel machine to a 9R track machine,
you double the footprint.
So that eliminates the ground compaction. And what about the four tracks? A four track you can order with an 18, a 24, a 30, or a 36 inch track. All of which that can be spread out to 120 inches. Now, a 9RX with a 36 inch track, you're gonna have up to 72 square feet of track on the ground. That's gonna drop your PSI compaction rate down to 5 to 6 pounds.
Think about what you can do with that.
How much sooner can we be getting in the field and what that can do for you? I invite each of you to come down here afterwards and we can talk about which 9R is right for you.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Scott Carr. I'm from El Campo, and my partner here beside me.
I'm Arthur Etheridge from El Campo. I'm the Integrated Solutions Manager and the Harvest Solutions Specialist as well.
Guys, in back of us, we have the new S700 combine, and actually this combine has been out. This will be its third season coming this year in 2020. So it's not too new to a lot of us, but I do want to touch on some of the new features for 2020. And one of them has to do with residue management on the back of the machine. I don't know if you're aware, but on the past models we had on the tailboard, the vanes were electronically adjustable, but the operator did have to switch that at the turn row, pass to pass. Now there is a auto swap feature on that. Also, this machine here is actually a 219. The 220s were not available, but there is a auto adjust knife bank. It's electronic actuators on either side. It's the same knife bank, but in the cab on the go, you can adjust from 0, 25, 50, 75, or 100% chopping, and that you can do on the fly as you determine. Also, what we'd like you to notice is on this unloading auger, there were some issues with the unloading height, and depending on the length of the auger and the tire package or the tracks, the increase in overall height jumped significantly from 9.5 to up to 12 inches. Also, how many people here like doing calibrations pre-season or in between different types of crops? Virtually nobody. And oftentimes they don't get done. On the moisture side of this combine, on the clean grain elevator, it has a zero calibration moisture meter on it. So it comes from the factory set, and you never have to calibrate the moisture meter, which is very nice.
And then also something that's significant, kind of insignificant, but on the crossovers and the hopper on the right-hand side of the combine.
In the evenings, if you want to clean grain out to keep moisture, rust, whatnot out of the tank, it's a quick release on those two augers, and these doors drop down, and so you can clean it out. That kind of covers the mechanical side of it. Arthur's going to touch on some of the data side and technology side. But there are some major takeaways on the S700 that I want to bring to attention, and some of this may be a little repetitive for some of y'all. But we still offer the same classes of machines. So we go from class six, handle 6-row, 8-row
corn heads, and up to 30-foot canner, depends on the material, up to 30-foot platforms.
And we also class 7, 8, and 9, so nothing changed there. But one thing I do want to point out that I don't know everybody's aware of is we do offer, it's industry exclusive, two distinctively different rotors. One of them is a tri-stream rotor. It's kind of a coarse grain for your corn type machines. It's a little gentler. The vanes on the top cover are fixed on that. but then in rice or tough threshings, they call it small grains, canola, things like that. We offer a variable stream, and that's what you'll see in our rice combines. And what that means was the crop comes from the feeder house
and transitions into the rotor, the kind of separator.
It has a much longer taper on the concave section. One thing that I would point out on the tri-stream, the coarse grain machine, has 15 threshing elements on the front of it. And on this rice package, small grain, there's 15 threshing elements, but there's also 12 more additional threshing tines, they call them. And I don't know
if you've seen it, machine to see them.
They're very aggressive. Help move that crop through.
Also, how about those tracks, Scott?
I also wanted to touch on the variable stream only. This is not available on that corn, the tri-stream, but on the variable stream on the top of it, there are vanes that direct the crop towards the back of the machine. They are electronically adjustable, so you can retard a crop that's a hard separating type crop,
such as rice, and so that's there. And also,
the main takeaway on our rotor machine that I wanted to point out was, I can remember this at the very first STS meeting, it is not a tube within a tube technology. It's not a perfect circle with an outer perfect circle. The rotor is a perfect circle, but the outer cage is elliptical. And on top, that radius is a larger radius. And so what happens is that crop travels around to the top, it gets released. And as that crop releases, centrifugal force can take place. And it's just a logical thing that grain can get driven to the outside, whereas it gets brought back down again on the separator grates, that it can actually separate and not end up as a loss at the back of the machine. One other point about that open concept or that elliptical design is it's less horsepower to run it. And then last but not least, I'm running out of time here, I wanted to touch on these tracks. Some people have had some issues possibly in the past. This is a John Deere design track. There's two options on the belts. There's a 30 inch width and a 36 inch width. On the 36, that's been by far the highest take rate. It's a 39 square foot surface area that you're putting on the ground. And some guys, absolutely the flotation's there in adverse conditions such as mud. But beyond that, even when conditions maybe aren't, some of these machines with 350 gallons of fuel, 400 gallons of corn in the tank, things of that nature, 16 row corn head, this machine can get up to around 92,000 pounds of weight, which is kind of extreme. But this does offer support, and from a secondary deal tillage behind this thing,
you might be knocking out 1-2 possible tillage passes, so we don't consider those things. But with that, I'm going to hand off to my boy Arthur.
Good evening.
The technology on this machine is, as always, phenomenal. We've always had auto track on combines. It works really good. This one goes above and beyond that with a new thing called Combine Advisor. And Combine Advisor utilizes two cameras their Activision cameras on the elevators, and you can set the machine how you want it, and it will actually maintain that throughout the field automatically. We can also get the data from your yield maps more accurate with the active yield in the hopper. And when you want to really get to optimizing your equipment, we can see what's going on in the field through an iPad. We can make adjustments remotely now with that Combine Advisor. And we're really excited about it. We really like to talk to you more about it. So when you get done, come on down and we'll see you down here.
Share a little story with you guys. I think I know just about everybody in this room pretty well. Maybe not everybody, but just about everybody. And standing here in these spotlights, it reminds me of a young boy in Raymore, Missouri, approaching his dad as he looks up to his dad with pride in his eyes, and he says, "Dad, someday I want to be in the spotlight. I want to be a rock star." And that boy's dad looked down at him and said, with all sincerity, "Son, you can't sing, you can't dance, and you can't play an instrument. Maybe you should sell tractors." So tonight is my rock star moment. So I tell you, if you just indulge me for 1 second, I hate to ask for a round of applause, but if I throw the rocks hard, can I get a clap for me right here? Forget about these tractors. I tell you, I'm blown. Thank you. Thank you for that. But hey, that's not why you came here. You came here tonight to look at what John Deere has done in row crop tractor technology. And I say technology because we're not just talking about nuts and bolts and rubber tires and tracks. We're going to talk about the technology that's in these tractors. Now, there's a few things that you saw when you first came up. The first thing is these lights are amazing. They're amazing. Matter of fact, when you order the signature package of the lights, they are 11% brighter in the front than what we had on the 8R 2019 models. What's more impressive than that, though, is on the sides and the back, they're 50% brighter than what we had before. Customers talk to Deere all the time, customer focus groups, and one of the things we heard was, we want more visibility. Well, starting with the lights, we've got more visibility. Another thing you probably noticed as you pulled up, the hood styling. I want each and every one of you, please, 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 come and take some time tonight. And look at the, get in these cabs of these tractors and look at the hood styling. Look at the visibility that's available today. There were other creature comforts that were talked about too. Now you can open the door from the ground. You don't have to climb up on the ladder to do that. You've also got lights right here to help you see at night when you're working those long hours. We've got a new seat available. We've got three packages of tractors. Now, I'm not going to bore you with details, but we've got three packages of tractors. We've got a select model, which is your standard mechanical seat. You know, more of the economy creature comforts. We go to a select, a premium, and then we get to the signature. And I want you to experience that signature seat. There were two seat simulators inside in the hall. If you didn't get a chance, sit in those. Under your left-hand armrest, flip it up. There's a heating button on there, a cooling button on that seat, and also self-massage. Ladies, you thought it was hard to get your husband out of the tractor. Now, it's really going to be tough. But some of you are saying, good, let him stay in there. I hear you. Okay, we've got, when we talk about the wheel, we've still got the same technology. We've still got the same tried and true wheel tractors that we've always had. We've got seven models from 230 horsepower up to 410 horsepower in the wheel tractors. We've also got the technology of a two-track machine. Trey Lucas talked about it back here with the 9RTs. We've got the same technology there in the two-track machine. But here is what I'm really excited about. We listen to customers. Customers said, our planting windows are getting tighter. Guys, it doesn't take long. Think about spring 2019. That was a tough spring. It stayed wet from September to March, and we didn't know how we were going to get in. Planting windows are tighter. The other trend in the industry we're seeing right now is high-speed tillage. People want to go faster with these high-speed dangling tools. With the VTs, Deere listened, and Deere came up with the solution. You talk about planting, getting in earlier. This four-track machine is 28% less compaction than what the same equipped tractor is in a wheel machine. 28%. Well, what does that mean to you? It means we can get into the field quicker. We can get in with less compaction. We're talking about this all the time. What kind of compaction are we doing with our equipment? We've got that ability in there as well now. You know, one thing I want to be very, very, very adamant about, this is not just a row crop tractor that we took the tires off of and bolted tracks up. That could not be farther from the truth. These tracks are CAMSO tracks designed for this 8RX tractor for John Deere and nobody else. These tracks are nowhere else, only on this tractor. Matter of fact, there's some changes here. When you come down, I want you to pay attention to the front axle. Because here on the Gulf Coast, we're a little bit different. We've got different row spacing. We're in beds. How's this gonna work? Well, this machine can be set on 76, 80, 88, or 120 inches. That 76 and that 80 inches fits our 38 and 40 inch rows, folks. And we do that by changing out a portion of the axle. Now, you've all heard of the 1300 axle. That was our original axle. You have the 1500 axle, which is a rigid axle as well, but capable of duals. Then we're all, everybody's favorite, the ILS. Well, now we're adding a new axle to these 8RXs. And just proving my point that we did not just bolt tracks onto this machine. We added a new axle, the new 1700 axle. Now, that axle comes along with tracks. You've got track sizes of 18, 24, and 30 inch widths. So we've got some flexibility there too. Just keep in mind that a 480 tire is an 18.9. So that 18 inch belt to stay in our middles may be the best bet, but it's something to talk about. You know, a few other changes that's different on the RX versus a wheeled or a two-track machine, the hitch is actually moved out farther in the back. The hitch is back farther so you can make a sharper turn. This tractor, compared to this tractor on 30-inch rows, will turn tighter than the wheel tractor. And the way it's designed, very little, if any, berming when you turn this machine. So that's why that hitch needs to be pushed out farther. Now, one more thing before we go on. I want to talk about one thing. Some of the toughest conversations I've had lately is with customers that say, Brad, I'm hearing about this cab suspension. Do I want cab suspension or do I want active seat? Well, just keep in mind, it's one or the other. Active seat is available in wheel tractors only. It's not available in the RX or the two-track machine, but cab suspension is. Take a look at the redesigned cab suspension when you come around and walk around these tractors. Take a look at that cab suspension. It is an industry leader. It is an industry leader. Folks, I can't touch on everything that we need to around these tractors, but in a little bit, we're going to open up this floor for you to come down, to sit in the cab, to take pictures, to ask questions. And those of you that know me, and you all do, it's the same old thing. You ask me a question, if I don't know the answer, I'm going to make something up. So just be prepared for that, because that's going to be kind of standard procedure with me. So, one thing before I let you go, you met Steve from the Hagee factory. We've also got Daniel Johnson, and I don't know if you're going to be able to see Daniel and Walt. They're up here in the stands. We've got Daniel Johnson and Walt Butler, our John Deere representatives. We could not do this if it weren't for those two guys helping us supply this equipment and provide for us here tonight. So please introduce yourselves to them. They're on this territory, they're here all the time, and I'd love for them to be able to put a face with a name. So with that being said, I'd like one more time, if I could direct your attention to the video boards for a quick video, and then Will Shoppa will address you from there. Thank you, everybody. I cannot thank you enough for your business. Thank you for your time tonight. I know everybody's busy, but thank you, thank you, thank you for being here. So please direct your attention to the video boards.
Eddie and I had always had a plan to return to Wharton after my retirement. We just liked the people here. The Bay City John Deere store became available, and Bay City was only 25 miles from home, so I met with the owner and negotiated a purchase agreement, and we bought our first dealership in 1982. It was good to get a business that you knew that if you could make successful, that you could pass it on from one generation to the next.
We're a company now of 8 locations spread out across 38 counties, and we have over 200 employees. We've created and expanded on the culture that my dad started at Shoppa's Farm Supply and building our brand.
It's really satisfying that I've seen the Shoppa organization grow and mature and have a reputation that you can be so proud of. This reputation is something you don't just get, you earn it.
It's a multi-generational company that still focuses on what's important.
They are still here working every day with us. They are very available. You can walk into their office, ask them a question if you need to. It's still family.
Being a third generation, getting the opportunity to come work here at Shoppa is a huge blessing. I was able to come in and overlap with my granddad for about a year and a half, and I work with my dad every day. I see his investment in the employees, investment in technology, his patience as some of his strengths.
I'm really, really proud of these guys. They worked hard, and they've done a great job at it, and under their leadership, it just grown and grown and grown.
There's no question that our hopes and dreams and aspirations for creating something that could be passed on has been achieved. That really kind of helps me feel like my dream, my life has been fulfilled.
Hi, I'm Will Shoppa, and once again, we just wanted to thank you for coming out tonight. We wanted to say that our team here at Shoppa's is very proud to serve you up on this upper Gulf Coast of Texas, and that we couldn't do it without you, and that we're looking forward to 2020 and all these innovations, and I won't hold y'all any longer from getting down here. So without further ado, please come on down to the floor. We'll be serving dinner in about 20 minutes. We'll open up the lines. So come on down and ask any of these experts questions, look around, kick the tires. And thanks again for being here, and thank you for your business.